Whenever I put out a video about a tool and how to use it, there's always going to be some questions. So this is a follow-up video on the one-to-many video that I've had before. Now, one-to-many in GEDmatch is a way to compare yourself to all of the other kits, basically to see who your match list is. And in particular, there's two questions about overlap that I want to cover today. Now, question number one is, what does the NA for overlap mean? Let's go over and take a look in GEDmatch here. I've gone to the one-to-many tool and put in my kit. On the very last column, we have the overlap value. And you can see here I have, you know, 500, 1,000, 400,000, 290,000, 200,000. Then I have a bunch of NAs and some more NAs. And you, when you're looking at your list, are probably going to see some of these NAs sprinkled throughout. And you might be wondering, okay, what does that mean? Well, real quick, let's just do a quick review of what overlap is to begin with. Overlap is when one company tests A, B, C, D, E, and another company tests C, D, E, F, and G. And so there's three of those that are overlapped that they can actually compare to. And so even though there may be 600,000 places that have been tested from your test, only 200,000 or 400,000 of them overlap with another company's site. And that's what's being compared in that one-to-one comparison, which is good because we're seeing some of these high values, but then it comes to the NAs. What does the NA mean? Well, let me adjust this a little bit to see if we can surmise why some of these are NA. So what I've done here is I have sorted this list by the overlap column. So you can see all of the NAs come up right here at the top. Now, if I look through these NAs, I can see over here, hey, total CMs, well, it spans the whole bit of everything. So it's not the total amount of shared centimorgans. Also, the largest segment spans from very small all up to very large. So that is not part of it. The xDNA is, you know, zeros to big numbers, almost the full chromosome. So that can't be part of what this NA has to do with. I'm going to go all the way over to this very far left column, which is the age. That means how long ago was this kit uploaded? So as I'm scrolling down here, I'm looking at the NAs over on the right side, and I'm looking at the age over on the left side. I'm seeing that most of these kits are 4 years old or more, it looks like. I see there's one that's 1,147, which is just over 3 years. But most of these are much more, including some that are almost, you know, 10 years, 9 years old or so. And there's none of these that look like they are below that 1,147 days. And that's all of these NA kits. So let me scroll down until I get to where some of these number ones are coming up, and we'll see what those look like. I've got a lot of NAs on mine. Okay, so here, well, there's a nice break, tells me we're into these other kits that I can see over here, 500,000, 400,000, 300,000, and this is all in order, and you'll notice, hey, this drops dramatically, whereas before I was seeing 1500s, 2000s, and 3000s some cases, I'm seeing a couple of thousands, but mainly, you know, below 1,000 as far as the total numbers. All the way down to brand new kits, 3 days that this kit has been on there. Now, I am seeing there's some that are more than that 1100. There, here's one that's 1600. As opposed to the 1100. So it looks like there is some overlap between the overlap NAs, if that makes a little bit of sense. Overlap in the age. But in general, you'll notice the vast majority of these are below 1000. So what is happening here? Well, this is where knowing a little bit about the history of GEDmatch comes into play. In other words, about 4 or 5 years ago, GEDmatch had been going on, and they had been created basically using Family Tree DNA and 23andMe data back from 2010. And that's what their database was centered around. Well, over the years, you had other players, Ancestry and MyHeritage and eventually Living DNA, that came into the picture, that they had their own chips. And likewise, 23andMe was changing their chip from what they had before to a different version that had a different set of SNPs. So there was no longer everything in the database that followed the general layout of what the database had been founded on. In about 2015, 2016, about 5 years ago or so, GEDmatch created a separate website that ran parallel called Genesis. And in this website, they were looking at some different ways of matching between these different kits to be able to come up with the same reliable data that they had from the other kits. Now, that went through a lot of different development. And at the time, you could actually upload to the regular site and you could upload to the Genesis site. Well, about 3 years ago or so, and if you're listening to these timeframes, you'll notice that they match up with some of the timeframes we were seeing. About 3 years or so ago, they decided that, hey, Genesis is going to be where we are going forward. We're going to stop. Everything that is uploaded is going to automatically be uploaded to both. And then there was a transition period where only Genesis was allowing new uploads, I think it was. Maybe I'm mistaking some of the things. But eventually, that Genesis site got morphed over onto the main site. So it became what GEDmatch was. And there was no old GEDmatch anymore. Well, one of the things that they had to do with the new uploads when they were building Genesis was take a look at this amount of overlap. And so the kits that were uploaded to the old GEDmatch website previous to that, that data was never really captured because they didn't need to capture it. There was no reason to. But with the new, that overlap was important to be able to see as part of their algorithms. And so it started capturing that. So really, when we're looking at this data over here, let me go back. What we're seeing is we're seeing that NA pretty much just means that this is a much older kit, 4 years or so older. And it was uploaded onto the old GEDmatch website. Whereas the kits that have the overlap data, if they are more than 4 years, which very few of them are, they were uploaded to the Genesis website as opposed to the GEDmatch website. And then eventually everything was uploaded through there. So while it would be great if we had that overlap data for all of these NA kits, the majority of growth on the GEDmatch website has occurred since that changeover. And so the majority of your matches you're going to see have some of that overlap data. Now, that is somewhat important, but not as critical as much of the other information that they provide for you. Let's go on to the second question related to overlap. And that is, what does the pink highlighted overlap mean? Now, this is a little bit of an easy question. I'll just go right back here to the data. And one of the things that you can see is when I sort the overlap from low to high, that way the NA is not on top there at the bottom, I have all of these pink ones here. And it's starting at 77,000 of overlap, 77,000 SNPs. And it goes up to about 90,000 SNPs. And that's what the pink means. Basically, there is less than 90,000 SNPs of overlap. Why would that be important? SNPs help you determine where segments are. And so the less SNPs, the less accurate your start and end locations for segments are going to be. And it's possible that you might get more false segments because of the lack of SNP overlap. That's just something to be aware of. It's not something necessarily to discount that match, but to be aware of as you're looking at that match that these things could occur. Typically, we're not looking at a single match at one time. We're looking at groups of matches together. Now, why would these kits have such low overlap below 90,000? And that clue can be found in this next column right here, the source. This kit that I have that I'm comparing is my 23andMe kit version 3. Now, for those of you who are familiar with this, version 3 was the most comprehensive as far as the number of SNPs. I think there was 950,000 SNPs on this kit. And this is basically one of the ones that GEDmatch used to create their database between this one and the Family Tree DNA kit. You're going to have your highest overlap when you're comparing a 23andMe with a 23andMe, both version 3 kits, and Family Tree DNA with a Family Tree DNA kit. But we're not always doing that. We're comparing them to Ancestry kits. We're comparing to MyHeritage kits. So for all of these low numbers, remember, one is a 23andMe version 3 kit. We have a bunch of 23andMes. It doesn't tell us what version, but then we start to have some clues here. We have 23andMe version 5. We have a living DNA. We have another 23andMe version 5, as well as some more 23andMes. But what you notice is that, hey, there's no ancestry in here. There's no family tree DNA. But we have living DNA and 23andMe, and then finally we have a MyHeritage down here. 23andMe, when they went to version 5, they used a new kind of chip. And that chip had very little overlap from their old chips. Living DNA, when they started, they were using this new type of chip as well. And so they had very little overlap with that, which is why when we're looking at low overlap, we're almost always looking at something compared to a 23andMe version 5 chip or a living DNA chip and some of the newer chips that Family Tree DNA and MyHeritage have just started using in the last, I want to say year. I can't remember for sure of when it was. As far as I know, Ancestry has not switched over to this newer chip. And so with your Ancestry, you're always going to see much higher amounts, about double what we're seeing. So for instance, as we go down through here, we see that, yeah, there's some Family Tree DNA that are low, some MyHeritage that are low. These are the new chips that Family Tree DNA and MyHeritage are using that are similar to the 23andMe version 5. But once we get to about 190,000, so almost 200,000, that's the Ancestry chip compared to the old 23andMe version 3 chip. And if we go all the way to the highest ones, not counting the combined, there is a 23andMe version 3 chip, or these are combined. This is a super kit, which is multiple kits all together, which is why it's so high. Here's some Family Tree DNA that's 300,000. Those are going to be the old one. Same with that MyHeritage. Those are the older chip that they were using that was much more similar to that 23andMe chip. So low overlap means you basically are comparing a different versions of chip, so there's not as much SNPs to compare. Now, if you would like to learn more about overlap, you can watch this video up here about overlap and what it means. Or if you want to watch something else about DNA, check out this video down below.